In a previous video, we talked about what foreign keys are and what purpose they serve. Now, let's take a look at how we can actually use foreign keys in SQL. We'll be using CockroachDB running on a free Cockroach Cloud account for our database, so check the video description for instructions on how to set that up for yourself. While this tutorial does focus on CockroachDB, the commands we're using here in the CockroachDB SQL shell will be the same or very similar to what you'd use in any SQL-based database system. Also, all of the commands that we're running in this tutorial are available in a .sql file that'll be linked in the video description below, so you can easily copy them, modify them, or even just run them directly from that file using CockroachDB. To add a foreign key constraint when we're creating a table, we just need to use the references command to specify the table and column we'll be linking to. Note that this command will fail if we try to link the table to something that doesn't exist, so we need to have created the other tables first. Just to break this command down, we're creating a table called orders. It has three columns, order number, user ID, and product SKU, and all of them use the integer data type. Order number is the primary key. User ID has a foreign key constraint that references the user ID column in the users table, and product SKU has a foreign key constraint that links it to the product SKU column of the books table. Once we've got a database, we can use show constraints from to see what constraints already exist and learn some details, including what type of constraint it is and what table and column it's referencing. Here are the two foreign key constraints we just created. The foreign keys we added don't include any instructions for how to handle when values in the reference table are updated or deleted, though. We can specify how our database handles it when a reference value is updated or deleted with the commands onUpdate and onDelete. Let's make that orders table again. This time, we'll specify that when a user ID or SKU is updated, we want that change to be reflected in the orders table as well. When a user is deleted from the database, we want to remove their orders from orders too. However, if a book is removed from the database, we just want to set the SKU in orders to null so that we don't lose the record of that order. Here's what the full create table command looks like when we've implemented those rules. We can also add new rules or remove old ones from an existing foreign key constraint with alter table and add constraint or drop constraint. For all of the details and options, check out the links to the foreign key documentation in the video description. In this video, we've taken a quick look at how to add foreign keys to a distributed SQL database and how to set up rules to define your database's behavior when a linked value is updated or deleted. We hope you found this video helpful. If you do have any questions, don't hesitate to drop them in the comments below. Also, don't forget to hit subscribe and be sure you don't miss more helpful content and tips to help ensure your application's database is fast, flexible, and unkillable.